A long, long time ago, it is said that twin boys were born to Mars, the god of war, and his wife Princess Rhea. They were named Romulus and Remus. When Princess Rhea's father, King Numitor, heard of the boys that had been born to Mars, he was afraid that the boys would grow up to overthrow him. He had them stolen and placed in a basket and put them to float in the river Tiber. The babies were discovered by a she-wolf who protected them till a shepherd found them and raised them into strong young men. They were natural leaders and warriors, and eventually they managed to kill the king. But rather than take the throne, they set out to build their own city. They finally came to a place that they liked, but both of them wanted the center of the city to be on different hills. The disagreement turned into a fight, and Romulus ended up killing Remus. Romulus finished the work on his city, and in 753 BCE, he made himself the king of the city and named it after himself, calling it Rome. The city that we know today was once the greatest empire known to man, and for 1,000 years, kingdoms all over the world aspired to be like Rome. Today we will turn back the pages of history and tell you the story, the grandeur, and the impact of the Roman Empire. Starting off as a city on a hill, Rome soon grew into a kingdom that was becoming famous in the neighboring lands. They grew in size by capturing neighboring kingdoms. When Rome captured a new kingdom, they would enter into a treaty with the kingdom, wherein they would become Rome's allies and would supply soldiers for the Roman legions. This is how the Roman legions kept growing and became mighty enough to take on any army in the world. It is said that at the time, Rome was such a respected and feared kingdom that a Roman citizen could freely walk around anywhere in the world and people would not harm him. After 37 years of rule, the great Romulus mysteriously disappeared when he was out reviewing his troops, and it is believed that he was sucked into a whirlwind. Many believed that he was called back to heaven by his father Mars, the god of war. In the beginning, Rome was ruled by kings, just like the rest of the world. But then around 509 BCE, King Lucius Tarquinius Superbus was overthrown by a few noblemen because they realized that handing all the power to a single king was leading to corruption and dictatorship. यहाँ से शुरुआत हुई रोमन रिपब्लिक की। इस रिपब्लिक में पूरे राज्य को चलाते थे रोमन कॉन्सल्स, जो इलेक्ट किए जाते थे, और उनके नीचे थे सेनेट, जिसमें 300 मेंबर्स थे, और ये कॉन्सल्स को एडवाइस करते थे। इस रिपब्लिक सिस्टम का एक एक्सप्रेशन था सेनेटस पॉपुलस रोमानस, यानी कि द सेनेट एंड द रोमन पीपल, जिसे सिंबल्स के तौर पे लिखा जाता था SPQR, और ये सिंबल्स आज भी आप रोम में देख सकते हैं। Over the next few hundred years, Rome conquered and grew, but there were cracks that were splitting up the empire from within. 49 BCE में रोम के कॉन्सल जूलियस सीजर ने अपने एम्पायर को एक्सपैंड करते करते इजिप्ट को भी पूरी तरह से कैप्चर कर लिया और वहाँ पे एक राजा की जगह एक रानी को पावर दे दी। उस रानी का नाम था क्लियोपेट्रा। धीरे धीरे सीजर खुद को डिक्टेटर बनाने की कोशिश में लग गया, और जब सेनेट मेंबर्स को ये पता चला तो उन्होंने सीजर को असैसिनेट करने का प्लान बनाया। वन डे व्हेन सीजर वाज मीटिंग हिज सेनेट, ऑल ऑफ देम टर्न्ड ऑन हिम एंड स्टैब्ड हिम वन बाय वन। This became one of the most famous betrayals in history and was also turned into a play by William Shakespeare by the same name. Even after Caesar, Rome saw some famous rulers like Nero, who was a cruel and evil ruler who played music as his city burned to the ground. There was also the philosopher king Marcus Aurelius, who was considered a just ruler, but his son Commodus turned out to be a bloodthirsty king who was more interested in gladiator games than ruling. Their story became the basis of the 2000s Oscar-winning film Gladiator. The glorious era of Pax Romana, or Roman peace, which lasted for about 200 years, came to an end with the rule of Commodus. Rome's contributions to mankind were not limited to kings and empires, and their glorious contribution to present-day literature and films. One of the major technologies that they mastered during their time was the aqueducts. this solved the water problems for the entire kingdom. These structures, using gravity, would carry water from water bodies and would transport them over miles to reach cities and towns. इन structures का ज़्यादातर हिस्सा ज़मीन के नीचे ही रहता था, और जो हिस्सा ज़मीन के ऊपर आता था, उसे खूबसूरत arches के साथ design किया जाता था। और इन aqueducts की strength और durability का अंदाज़ा इस बात से लगाया जा सकता है कि इनमें से कई आज की तारीख में ना सिर्फ खड़े हैं, बल्कि एक तो आज भी usable है। The Aqua Virgo that still brings water to Rome from nearby springs after more than 2,000 years. Incredible, right? Along with swords and spears and shields, the Romans also knew how to use precision tools for medical purposes. Roman armies even employed trained medical professionals to use these tools on the battlefield to treat wounded soldiers. क्या आपको पता है? आज हम पूरी दुनिया में जो कैलेंडर यूज करते हैं उसे ग्रेगोरियन कैलेंडर कहते हैं, मगर इसका इस्तेमाल शुरू हुआ था 1752 एडी में। उसके पहले यूज हुआ करता था रोमन्स का दिया हुआ जूलियन कैलेंडर। जूलियस सीजर के आदेश पे बना ये कैलेंडर दुनिया का पहला कैलेंडर था जहां साल की शुरुआत 1 जनवरी को होती थी और जिसमें हर चौथे साल में एक एक्स्ट्रा दिन हुआ करता था, जिसे आज हम लीप ईयर कहते हैं। With time, changes were made to this calendar, and eventually in 1582, Pope Gregory XIII made slight changes to this calendar and came up with the Gregorian calendar, which eventually was universally accepted in the year MDCCLII. समझ में नहीं आया? ये है 1752, जिसे लिखा गया है Roman numerals में. आज ये Roman numerals शायद कुछ clocks पर या पुरानी buildings पर नजर आते हैं, मगर कई सेंचुरीज तक इन रोमन न्यूमरल्स को स्टैंडर्ड माना जाता था। मगर 14th सेंचुरी के बाद धीरे धीरे अरबिक न्यूमरल्स का इस्तेमाल शुरू हो गया एंड इवेंचुअली दे बिकेम द स्टैंडर्ड फॉर द वर्ल्ड। मगर जहां रोमन अल्फाबेट्स की बात आती है तो वो तो आज भी दुनिया भर में यूज होते हैं। जी हाँ, जो इंग्लिश के 26 अल्फाबेट्स हम यूज करते हैं वो सब रोमन अल्फाबेट का हिस्सा है। If you were to visit Rome today, one of the major attractions would be Vatican City, a city-state that is the home of Christianity and the home of Pope, and a place that attracts more than 50 lakh visitors every year. But Rome was not always the home of Christianity. In fact, it was under the leadership of Emperor Tiberius that Jesus Christ was crucified and killed. Over the following years, Romans tried to bring down Christianity by punishing or killing the people who practiced it. It was only in 324 AD that Constantine the Great made all religions equal and Christianity could be openly practiced. And finally, in 379 AD, Theodosius I made Christianity the official religion of the Roman Empire. With expressions like, Rome was not built in a day, all roads lead to Rome, and when in Rome, do as the Romans do. It is clear that the impact of this long-lost civilization is enduring and will remain for a long time to come. Humans have as much to learn from the rise of the Roman Empire as they have from its decline. But most of all, we have a lot to thank them for. And if you think that your knowledge of ancient civilizations is good enough, log on to Mind Wars and test yourself against the best. Want to be the first to know of the videos on the Mind Wars YouTube channel? Hit subscribe and click the bell icon. And remember, knowledge increases when you share it. So like, share and tell your friends about the video.